Is your child's health being silently sabotaged by hidden toxins? Are you overwhelmed by all the conflicting information out there about detoxing for autism? Hi, I'm Dr. Theresa Lyons. I'm a Yale University trained scientist and autism parent, and I teach parents like you the cutting edge science of autism so that you can make the best decisions for your child based on quality information. Today, we're breaking down the myths and facts about detoxification in autism. I'll share practical, evidence-based guidance that can empower you on your journey. Let's get started. What exactly is autism detoxification? Simply put, detoxification refers to the process of removing toxins from the body. Very simple, right? But when it comes to autism, the conversation gets a bit more complex. Some believe that detoxifying the body can alleviate certain symptoms of autism. But is that really true? Before you jump into any detox program, it's crucial to understand what science actually says about it. Detox for autism is not a one-size-all solution. It involves understanding the unique needs of your child and taking a cautious, evidence-based approach to detoxing. Stick with me to the end of this video and you'll have a clearer idea of what works, what doesn't, and what you should be cautious about. Let's dive into the science. Our bodies naturally detoxify through many different complex biochemical pathways. Cerebral spinal fluid is one way that happens while we sleep. Another way is the methylation cycle, which helps remove toxins from the body. However, in some individuals with autism, these pathways might not function as efficiently as others. Methylation, for example, is a key detoxification process. Think of it as your body's special detox squad. When it's not working properly, toxins can build up, potentially worsening autism symptoms. But it's not just about one pathway. There are other detox mechanisms like transsulfuration that also play critical roles in detoxification. Okay, what's the science? There are published scientific articles suggesting a connection between impaired detoxification mechanisms and autism. But remember, while there's scientific backing these processes, it doesn't mean that every detox method out there is safe or effective or exactly what your child needs. That's the important part. What does your child need? What toxins are we talking about? So there's heavy metals like lead and mercury. There's pesticides. There's mycotoxins. There's other environmental chemicals. And they have been linked to autism in some studies. These toxins can interfere with brain development and function, potentially exacerbating autism symptoms. Remember, we are talking about correlation here, not causation. A study by DeSoto found a correlation between mercury levels in the blood and autism diagnosis, while others have linked elevated levels of urinary porphyrins, a marker for lead toxicity, with autism severity. Do heavy metal exposure really matter with kids? Yes! In the US, lead exposure is routinely tested for in pediatric well visits because of its known dangers. So if a child has high levels of heavy metals, autism or not, it should be addressed. But before you panic, it's important to know that the mere presence of these toxins doesn't always mean they're causing symptoms. So it's really important to tease that out. Detoxification needs to be approached cautiously, focusing on methods that are safe, evidence-based, and tailored to your child's unique needs. All right, now let's talk about the gut, often called the second brain. Many people don't realize that gut health plays a significant role in detoxification, especially for children with autism. Gut issues like leaky gut syndrome and constipation can actually hinder the body's ability to eliminate toxins efficiently. So then things start to build up. So how do we start to support the gut? Here are some very simple starter ways. So going organic. So you actually reduce the amount of chemicals that your child is eating. Eating healthy fats, which can help decrease inflammation in the gut. There are certain supplements to take that also help support the gut, such as digestive enzymes, vitamin D, fish oil, magnesium. I know these are basic supplements. You've probably heard of them already. If not, it's definitely good to learn. And you yourself can start doing the research on them and get those supplements going, even if you're not working with a functional medicine doctor yet. And if a functional medicine doctor does not discuss these basic first step supplements with you, get a new doctor. Do not waste time with a doctor who doesn't know what they are doing. There are much more advanced supplements and prescriptions that support the gut and detoxification. There are many binders. An example would be GI Detox, HMET binder, chlorella, activated charcoal. Then you can move into Sporinox and Wellcol, EDTA, DMSA, and there's so much more. Those last few actually require prescriptions. So make sure you're working with a doctor who knows what they're doing. These are all advanced, what I just mentioned, and you would not want to use any of them without knowing what toxin you are trying to detox. You can't just do a general detox and hope you get what is causing the problem. It might be appropriate to incorporate probiotic foods like yogurt or sauerkraut. Start small with that stuff. And prebiotic foods found in bananas, onions, and garlic that can help restore healthy gut flora. High fiber foods such as oats, apples, and broccoli can also aid in digestion and toxin elimination. Please be mindful of food sensitivities, and also if your child has other issues at the same time. For instance, if they have high arabinose levels, then bananas would not be a good food choice to get prebiotics. Knowing information like this will help you avoid a setback or a regression, which then impacts your motivation. And you don't want that. You want to do something and see beneficial changes. And regressions really impact parents' motivation. I want you to believe that there is a better future, because there is. Have you tried any specific foods or supplements to support your child's gut health? Share your experiences in the comments. Your story might help another parent out there. Now, let's talk about another important factor in detoxification, oxidative stress. You might have heard of this term, but what does it really mean? Oxidative stress happens when there's an imbalance between free radicals, which are unstable molecules that can cause damage to cells, and antioxidants, which are the body's natural defense against these harmful molecules. You need a good balance. Elevated oxidative stress levels are often found in individuals with autism. There's science about that. And they can impact the body's ability to detoxify effectively. To understand if oxidative stress is affecting your child, certain blood tests can provide valuable insights. These include tests for high glutamic acid, high triglycerides or total cholesterol, low B vitamin 12, low glutathione or NAC, and low vitamin D. If you think detox might be an issue for your child, these tests can help you identify what areas to focus on to support their overall health. All right, let's circle back to diet, because diet is one of the most impactful ways to support detoxification. And I know, I realize this might be a sensitive topic. Making diet changes are difficult, but what I've observed is that changing diet and also changing on improving some of these health issues, everything goes faster when both are changed. You get that synergy. So it's possible to power through and not change diet, but then usually parents are giving much more supplements, and some of it is just to counteract what the child is eating. So it's like taking two steps forward, eating junk, and taking one step back. That's not fun. You want to go forward. A clean diet for autism means prioritizing unprocessed foods. Think organic fruits and vegetables and lean proteins, grass-fed, grass-finished, all that good stuff. Foods rich in antioxidants like blueberries and spinach and nuts. But again, please be mindful of food sensitivities of your child. An elimination diet can also be beneficial, and this involves removing potential allergens such as gluten or casein, spinach, bananas, anything which really may aggravate gut issues in your child. So always consult with a healthcare provider before making any drastic dietary changes. What is a clean diet for autism? What is the elimination diet for autism? If you had success with any particular diet for your child, let us know in the comments below. Let's share ideas and support each other on this journey. Additional methods for detoxification. Beyond diet, there are several other methods that people use to detoxify the body, especially in the context of autism. One popular yet controversial method is chelation therapy. This involves using either supplements or prescriptions to remove heavy metals like lead and mercury from the body. While some believe it can help reduce certain symptoms, it's important to know that chelation therapy carries significant risks, including potential damage to the kidneys and the brain. Chelation therapy is effective when it's appropriate for the child, and it should only be done under medical supervision. Chelation should only be considered under the strict guidance of a qualified healthcare professional. They are out there, you just have to find them. Safety must always come first. Chelation therapy certainly can impact and improve the health of your child if heavy metals is an issue. Other methods, such as Epsom salt baths, are gentler. These baths can help relax muscles. You can incorporate aromatherapy and have relaxation and multi-senses. And it can also support magnesium levels, which can aid in detoxification, but from a very gentle overall approach. Similarly, sauna therapy is another option thought to help eliminate toxins through sweat. However, it's crucial to ensure your child is hydrated and comfortable during these sessions. Sauna is great for detoxifying something like mycotoxins, but it's typically not the first choice for something like heavy metals. So you've got to know, again, what toxin are you focusing on and match the appropriate therapy to that. Digestive enzymes are another option that can aid in breaking down food and supporting gut health, potentially reducing symptoms related to poor digestion, and making sure your child gets as much nutrients from whatever food that they're eating as possible. Also, complete digestion is important so that in the large intestine, pathogenic bacteria are not given the opportunity to overpopulate. I'm sure many of you have heard about the research that the bacteria composition in a person's gut is different for those with autism than others. And if you're trying to impact certain populations of bacteria in the large intestine, then digestive enzymes are vital. Remember, every child is unique, and what works for one may not work for another. And that's okay. It's just important to figure out, what does your child need? Always choose safe options and consult with healthcare professionals who understand your child's specific needs, and use lab testing to create the healthcare strategy that will impact your child. You want to test before the treatment and then after the treatment so you can see how effective the treatment was. And then you can make your next step decisions based on actual data, not on someone's opinion or feeling or anything like that. Use science, use data. Myths and misconceptions about autism detoxification. Now let's debunk some common myths. Myth number one, detox can cure autism. In the scientific literature, cure is not the word used. Optimal outcome or non-persistent autism is how it's described in the scientific literature. There are case studies published that show when there is an appropriate focus on detox and the detox is successful, an optimal outcome can be achieved. Now, these are case studies. They're not large clinical trials. Usually, it's not one thing that provides an optimal outcome, so please keep that in mind and have realistic expectations. Myth two, all detox methods are safe. Not true. Even well-established methods of detox can be dangerous if not followed properly. For example, sauna. It is great for detoxifying certain toxins, not all. But sauna could be dangerous if not given enough hydration or by doing too much too quickly. Some supplements and therapies marketed as detox solution may have dangerous side effects or interact poorly with other treatments and other supplements that you're given. So no, all detox methods are not safe. It's essential for you as the parent to get educated and to prioritize evidence-based practices and consult trusted healthcare providers who can guide you through safe and effective options. Stay informed, be skeptical of miracle cures, and always choose science-based approaches for your child's well-being. Optimal outcomes are possible. Just use science to get you there. So what's the best approach if you're considering detox for your child? Start small and simple. Introduce more whole foods like organic fruits and vegetables to minimize toxin exposure. Focus on hydration. Water is a natural detoxifier. Support the gut with basic supplements mentioned. Look at your child's environment and make sure that you identify where the toxin is coming from and stop it so that they're not continually being exposed. That makes detoxing virtually impossible. If you're detoxing but introducing at the same time, you're just treading water. You're going to get nowhere. It's really important to identify what is the toxin and where did it come from and make sure it's not continually being introduced to your child. Safe detox practices. Always do testing first to make sure that a detox program is necessary. Not all kids with autism have detox issues. Many yes, but not everyone. Use science to guide you so you don't make mistakes and waste time or money. Monitor your child's progress closely and watch for any signs of discomfort or adverse reactions. Sometimes detoxifying goes too fast. You just got to ease up a little bit. And always retest in a short amount of time to measure how effective the treatment is. Keep a diary of your child's symptoms and any changes you notice, and share this information with your healthcare provider. This will help you make informed decisions moving forward. Now, you might be wondering, wait, what about genetic testing? Genetic testing might be appropriate after you have done some lab testing to identify the cause, identify the toxin, remove it, start a treatment approach, start to see some progress. That's usually when you start to plan for the future. How do I make sure this doesn't happen again? A lot of times that's when it's most appropriate to do some of these genetic tests so that you can really understand what kind of supplements are going to be needed for the future, if any. Feeling overwhelmed by all the information about autism and detoxification? Don't worry, I'm here to help. Click the link below to learn more about how we can work together. I'll break down the science and guide you with clear, actionable steps tailored to your child's unique needs. Let's make this journey easier and more empowering together. What's been your experience with detox methods for autism? Share your story in the comments below. Your insights could be a huge help to another family on a similar journey. And remember, we're all in this together. Knowledge is power. Stay informed, stay empowered, and trust that you're making the best decisions for your child. Thanks for watching, and see you soon.